In 2024, learn these 24 Xcode keyboard shortcuts to streamline your workflow and enhance your productivity. These shortcuts expedite common tasks from navigating through code to swiftly accessing specific panels. In an era where time is of the essence, utilizing keyboard shortcuts not only accelerates development, but also fosters a more streamlined coding experience. Let's incorporate these 24 shortcuts into your daily routine. And if you'd like to escape tutorial hell in 2024, go ahead and check out reveloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. So today, we are going to learn 24 keyboard shortcuts for Xcode so you can boost your productivity in 2024. So right off the bat, we are going to learn how to build. So Command B is the shortcut for building your project. Of course, that's just going to build. If you want to build and run, so Command R is going to run your actual project, of course, to the selected target that you have. I have simulated right over here. If you want to stop running it, you want to go for Command and the dot, and that will just simply stop your project from running. Now, if you want to open quickly some file, you just go Shift Command O. And then, you know, just, I just have this content. It's really nice because I just going to jump to the content view or whatever file you want. Also works with methods and functions. Now, if you have a really, really big project, maybe you want to clean the build folder, and that is done with Shift Command K. And that will just clean the build folder of your project. Let's say that we have a lot of bad indentation right over here. And if we want to indent all of your code, you just want to either select some part of your code, or some of these lines or the specific lines, or just select everything with Command A. And then you just hit Control I, and that will indent everything. Okay, that's how to re-indent the code really nicely. Now, if you want to find the text in your project, you just go Shift Command F, and that will open up this finder, and you can just search for, I don't know, hello, hit return, and it's just going to have containing, matching words, starting with, ending with. Let's just have that inside our find text, and then hello. As you can see, it's really, really versatile. With a wealth of experience and expertise in iOS development, I bring a unique blend of practical knowledge and industry know-how to the table. My mentoring approach goes beyond the conventional teaching methods, providing personalized and hands-on guidance tailored to each individual's skills levels and goals. I am committed to empowering iOS developers with the tools they need to succeed in today's competitive app development landscape. Join me at reveloper.com/mentoring and elevate your iOS development skills to new heights. Now, if you want to show the standard editor, which is this one, then you are going to hit Command and Return, and that will just show you only the standard editor. One of my favorite ones, just going to declutter my view. Now, if you want to show the assistant editor, now in Swift UI, it's not really important, but in UIKit, it is. So if you just hit Control, Option, Command, and Return, that will open up your assistant editor. Of course, here we don't have it. It's just going to show this view. Let me just close that for you. Now, if you want to collapse a single block of code, well, you can do it with a mouse if you want to, but there's an easier way with a shortcut, of course, and that is Option, Command, and then either forward or backward arrow. So, you know, just there we go. Of course, you want to stay on the V stack and just want to collapse all of that. If you want to collapse everything, you just prepend Shift and then Option Command and then the forward and backward arrows. Really, really nice. Now, if you want to jump to a method, just go Control 6 and then you can just go up and down with the arrows and then hit return and you would just jump to that method. how to show and hide the debug area. Well, as you can see, now it's open. I can just hit Shift and then Command Y, and that will just close it. Of course, it will just open it by Shift Command Y again. Now, how to hide and show the navigator? That's really easy. Command 0. Command 0 again. There we go. Now, what about the utilities? It's Option Command 0. There it is. Really, really nice. Option Command 0. Let me just hide that. I don't really like to use the utilities myself. What if you just want, text completion? You can just go with Ask to toggle it off and then Ask again to show it. Okay, that's how you show and hide the completions. Now, sometimes you want to comment and uncomment things really quickly. Now we are in one line, just go Command forward slash, and that will just uncomment that one line of code. Of course, you can just may select multiple lines and then again Command forward slash to uncomment. It's really, really versatile. Now, if you want to jump to definition, you can just right click and go and jump to definition. But there's an easier way, and that is Control Command J. And then you just select return, and it will just jump to that definition. Really, really nice. Now, also, if you like the canvas in SwiftUI, you can toggle it on and off by Option Command Return. So again, Option Command Return will just show the canvas. If I hit Option Command Return one more time, that will hide it. Now, you can also reorder your lines of code. So we are right over here with the text of Hello World, and I go for Option Command and either opening square brackets or closing square brackets. So it will just go up and down just like that. Of course, this also works with multiple lines, so I'm just selecting multiple of these, like these three, and then Option Command, and then just using those to either opening or closing square brackets. Now, you can also resume automatic previews like that. Let me just hit again Option Command and return to show the preview, and let's just add in this kind of error so there is no preview. Of course, you can just tap right over here if you want to. That's great. But you can resume automatically with Option Command and P. So it's just going to start again to reload the preview. Of course, now we have an error. That's fine. You can just jump over there. If your preview hangs, use Option Command Pre. Let me just come back over here. Now, you also can toggle the minimap, and I'm going to close now the canvas. You can toggle the minimap on and off by Shift, Control, Command, and M. Again, if you just hit Shift, Control, Command, M, you can just toggle it on and off. Now, what if you just want to duplicate some lines? Well, let's just duplicate this one line. Hit Command D, and it will just duplicate. It's really, really nice. And also, if you want to jump to a line, then you can just hit Command L, and then type in the line, 15, hit Return, and you will jump to that line. Hopefully, all of these shortcuts are going to make your lives a little bit easier in Xcode, and it will just, I'm pretty sure that it will boost your productivity with it. And if you'd like to talk with me on a one-on-one session, make sure to check out redeveloper.com/mentoring. The link is down in the description.